All right, let's play the Oregon Trail. Let's go ahead and start our journey. Just gotta get to Oregon City. Easy peasy. It's only like that far away. Travel, take a journey across 2,000 miles of plains, rivers, and mountains. If for some reason you don't survive, your wagon burns, or thieves steal your oxen, or run out of provisions, or you die of cholera, don't give up. Try again and again and again and again. This will be easy. Adventurer. She's kind and charming. A missionary is pessimistic and dim-witted. A banker, egotistical and funny. Take a banker. I guess we'll do... a farmer who's hedonistic and slack. Sure. And then a missionary who is... charming and heroic. Oh yeah. This is going to be great. Boom, boom. All right, well, let's customize. Now, we'll 50 bullets, flour. 200 meat. I'll take that one. So we got some tools. We got some bullets. Some flour. A little bit of medicine. Two grease packets, some clothes, a book, harmonica, got a little bit of extra money. How many parts? Do we have any spare parts? Or at least take a spare wheel. Yeah, I'll definitely want a wheel. And probably some more bullets. Something like that. Okay. Alright, we'll go down. Pay for our purchases and head on out. Let's talk. Moses Harris. Oh, I love his music. Oh, yeah. Boom. The party has heard of the famous mountain man of Moses Harris is staying in town. Decides to check, seek his advice. Unfortunately, they find him in a rather poor condition. He's laid out in his hotel bed, dehydrated, clearly in pain. Despite his suffering, he agrees to talk to about the party and share what wisdom he has. Ask about health. I don't imagine I have much time left. I feel like I've got a different sort of journey ahead of me, and I'm going to somewhere that I haven't been before. Nothing's to do but face what's been put in front of us. I have to make this journey alone. Despite his suffering, he agrees to talk to the party and share what wisdom he has. What adventure. Moses tells a story about, we were out in the Black Hills, no meat, snow 50 foot deep. One day, we crossed the canyon and made it to the prairie. There was green grass, green trees, and birds singing. All this in February. We sung out, hoo-ah! I was hungry, so I went for one of those singing birds. The critter came down in pieces, head rolling right off its body and still singing. It was made of stone. His eyes are wide as he recalls the shocking details. Took an axe to the tree, got nothing but stone. All our animals stood shaking over the grass, and I swear it was made of stone too. Meant a whole petrified forest. Douglas? Greetings. You head to Oregon? It's been quite a journey already, hasn't it? It's meant to get harder from here. Perhaps you can help me out. I met this woman here. Ava was her name. You haven't met her, have you? Who's Ava? She's incredible. Dysentery is nasty, and you don't want to know what it is, but it's bad. And people died of it a lot. It's really, really terrible. I'll ask about Ava. Sure. Let's depart. Chocobo Tamer, thank you for the 131 month resub. Says, hi Dan, you're cool. Thank you. Thank you so much. Appreciate that. All right, let's go to Kansas River Crossing. All characters must survive. Avoid contacting cholera. Easy. Let's go this way. Morning breaks independence. Our intrepid travelers take the first steps in the Oregon Trail. Spirits are high. Everyone's in peak physical condition. The wagon is stocked. The party's filled with vim and vigor. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. While gathering water for the camp, Roy finds some turtle eggs buried on the bank of the nearby waterway. Eggs can be gathered and cooked for food, though some of the party may find such an act unsavory. Let's gather the eggs. First side to gather the eggs, regrettable for the mother turtle, perhaps the unnecessary sacrifice. Aww. Well, we got delicious food though, right? Yeah. Hashtag worth it. Who are these people? Hello. Several travelers are celebrating their journey. Whether they're honoring their victories or commemorating their fallen is unclear. Party may be able to join the celebration to restore some morale. No, we'll just push on. We're good. Play some sort of restores morale, sure. Everyone's looking good so far, though. No issues. What in the fuck? Parties quit lost for words. Not every day that the man falls from the sky. Regardless, seeing the man fall, chat all typed Dan fall collectively in amazement. Are you okay, sir? Counts aren't at all. Looks like I run out of steam again. I knew these engines were nothing but trouble. Trains man dusts himself off. Excuse me, where are your manners? My name is Samuel Pepper, and I thank you kindly for your help just now. What you just witnessed was my latest invention, a flying machine. Though I admit it's something of a work in progress. All that's missing is the raw source of power. Steam engines, modern though they may be, are not simply up to the task. Samuel Pepper strokes his chin with a thought. You're quite right to be impressed. I have studied the work of Sir George Calvey, an English inventor who already built a working heavier-than-air glider. It's only a matter of time for him, and he achieves the dream of powered flight. My dream is that America can be the first to make such a flight. Indeed, if the winds are favorable, see no reason why it shouldn't be me. Sam Pepper looks excited. It's a pleasure to meet you. Perhaps we'll see each other again. After all, who knows what the future holds? I shall never despise you from above. Right. Goddamn America. No dysentery yet. It's still early, though. There's still plenty of time for dysentery. There's no great spot here. I'm just gonna go... we'll just leave it there. It's fine. Party stumbles across an impromptu chair wedding. The crowd's cheering, celebrating the love of a young couple. The party... could opt it to join in or just keep it to themselves. Let's celebrate. There's UI literally at every inch of this screen. I'm just gonna have to put it somewhere and just except that we're gonna cover something. Food stuff, hours lost, foodstuffs. In the morning, the celebrants have cleared out, leaving the party low on the trail. The group also left small crate of food stuff for the party, by the way, thanks to the company. Oh. Well, thank you. Just go full screen. No. Snake? Group notices the flour supply is getting low. We should bake some hardtack. Party groans at the suggestion. Hardtack will stretch supplies longer, but taste miserable. It should be done. Let's cook some of it. Flour is baked with a number of hard, dry biscuits. So good. Can you hear that? River's up ahead. Now, don't even think about fording the river deeper than the wagon bed, about 2.5 feet. You'll swamp your wagon and lose your supplies. You can caulk the wagon bed and float it, or be smart and hire me to take your wagon on my ferry. Why not have a look around before you decide? You can talk to me anytime you want to hear about the rope crossing options again. Those people got any quests? Well, how much? The ferry is $5 per person and... The depth's 2.1 feet. Let's haggle. Let's do our banker, which is Eliza. Well, I think that's fair. Very operator slightly reduces his price. It'll be $4 a person instead of oxen. Hell yeah. All right, let's go. That ferryman is paid and why do waits take their turn on the ferry? Well, we're just gonna take the ferry, play it safe. Had to wait for my turn though. Ah, we made it safely. Party alights from the ferry after a pleasant ride across the river. Ooh, we got 49 money back for not everyone dying. So it was basically free. let's go that way. Invigorated, they continue on their journey. £12 of food a day. Strenuous. We're fine. Don't gotta read just yet. Just this game is you're traveling to Oregon and then gotta try not to die while getting there. And you can get sick, you can get robbed, stolen, attacked, mugged. Welcome, travelers. Step right up and play our game. My brothers and I will shuffle ourselves around. When we stop, see if you can pick me out. Choose correctly, and all manner of rewards yours to keep. How about it? Wager $10 seem fair? What do you say? That seems like a scam, but sure, let's play it. Excellent. Now let us play. Say when you're ready. I'm in the middle. Uh-oh. Follow me. Leftmost. Felicitations, you got me! A sterling effort, travelers! Here's your reward. Hope to see you again. Wow, we got 50 bucks, 75 flour, and 2 coffee. Oh, God, we rich. That was damn good. The wagon is wearing out. Uh-oh. Repack. Please repair that. Thank you. And put it back in there. So thirsty. The party's water supply has run low. If it's not refilled before too long, dehydration and death may be the result. A small pond can be seen just off the trail. A few mosquitoes larvae swimming lazily on the surface. Without restocking the water supply, the party's morale and stamina are sure to decline. Should the water supply be replenished? Oh God, no. That's like dysentery water. So no. That would be a whole lot worse. Party avoids the dubious pool. With their clean water supply dwindling, they're forced to ration what remains. Deep weariness begins to set in. Oh no. Yeah, that mosquitoes mean that the water is stagnant. When stagnant water is what grows bacteria and anime fans and stuff. Several travelers mill about, wagons unpacked and campfires lit. This seems to be popular camping ground. Maybe safe to restore stamina. Sure, let's camp. Let's stargaze. Oh, that's pretty. Step and Razor and Death's Favorite, thank you for those resubs, guys. Tell stories. Party stays up late at night telling stories about their lives around the warm, flickering light of the campfire. Oh, we gotta learn some skills about people. Party returns from the trail, though they didn't get a good rest. They managed to learn a little more about each other. Hail to the air. Death's Favor, thank you for the resub, 122 months. Appreciate that. Oh, no. The wagon's wheel, back wheel catches on one of the trail's myriad ruts. It sticks and jams fast. We'll move no further. As things stand, pushing the wagon free will strain the party. Or...
Hi.
As things stand, one might unpack its cargo, lighten it first, which would be tolerably safer, but the cargo is unloaded, the longer the process will take. What should the party do? Let's unpack some stuff. Now let's push it out. Party and oxen strain mildly to achieve the task, and in time, the wagon rolls free once more. Party continues towards a big blue river. This is not going good so far. Where is, like, clean water supply? I don't see that, like, as a resource. Maybe it's not one. Let's use our coffee. We're all getting low, and we also could use some morale, so let's use the... Never mind. Thought I had something for morale. Looks like we don't have anything. Composure. Gain one composure. Religious characters, missionaries gain double. What does composure do? Yeah, Bibles are disposable now. You can't, like, just reuse your Bible. I mean, come on. Read it once and throw it away and get another one. The roaring of a fast-flowing river could be heard ahead, long before it comes into view. This is the Big Blue River, and an infamously difficult crossing. Alright, let's talk to people who are here first. No one here has any quests or anything. Trade-in. Let's see what people got. Three pelts, toolboxes, nope, I don't need any of that. Alright, how are we gonna cross here? Let's see, first let's rest. It can slightly improve river conditions. Okay, let's try crossing, see what the river's at. 8.4 feet, oh dear god. Cock the wagon. 49. Oh no. I don't have any pelts. Cocking it is probably our best bet, but. I'm gonna have to trade for those pelts that guy has. I'll take some pelts, sir. Here, you can have three clothes. Alright, let's cross. We will... For the wagon, is zero chance. Alright, so let's do caulk. using three pelts. It's a 64% chance to work. Let's wait for conditions to improve. That's a little better. Lucy Morale is gone. Alright, 68. This is fine. Let's go. Alright, let's go. It's gonna be fine. 72% now. Okay, let's go. Going great. I think we're fine. This is gonna go perfectly. No issues at all. It's fine. We did it! Hooray! Despite the wagon not being completely sealed, the party manages to cross the river without their supplies suffering any water damage. A result born of pure luck, perhaps, but sometimes exactly what one needs to survive the trail. Thank you, Kalk. We didn't get dysentery. Yay. Looks like he wants me to go that way. With the big blue river behind them, the party looks ahead with some trepidation. They only hope the trials to come aren't as treacherous. Roy checks the bags of flour, then recoils in disgust. Inside is a picture of DansGaming. Ew. It's infested with weevils. Should the flour be discarded? Or should the party keep at it? Discard it. Roy dumps flour on the trail side. At least weevils will be well fed. What a waste, I know. We need morale increase. Well met, travelers. Good to see you again. Sam and Pepper waves hello. I decided to stop my work on my flying machine for now. General principles are sound, but I believe I'll have to wait for advent a more powerful engine. Besides which, I have yet to solve the issue of how to safely land. He nurses his bruised arm. In the meantime, I've got to work on a new invention. A little more down to earth, I admit, though I believe it'll be revolutionized travel regardless. Encourage him. Steve, thank you for that resub, it says Dan Love. Why are you playing this, mate? Because it's fun. Do you need another reason than that? Sam Pepper looks quite pleased with himself. As I was plummeting to the ground, I had a revelation, a vision of the wind rushing through my hair. Yes, I shall build a new wagon, powered entirely by poop. I mean, wind. Why walk to Oregon when you can sail? Samuel Pepper is overcome with excitement. We got to play the OG version of this in school, and I learned so much. I didn't learn anything, but it was fun just to play games, you know? Did your school also have those colorful Macintoshes? We had those big, giant computers that had the Apple logo on them. Yeah, I think those were Macintoshes. They ran slow as hell, and they barely did anything, but we got to play on them. I think our school had, like, five, and then they were on a, like, something that rolled. And only five people at a time could play. And we'd have to take turns. We got to play Oregon Trail, and then we got to play Caesar. Let's rest. Oh god, our morale is bad. I was reading the tack, hard tack. Ugh. Ox has spent several hours slowly enjoying the meal. They seem fresh and good-spirited by the time the party is ready to set out. We gotta improve our morale. We need either liquor or... I don't know, something to improve morale. Maybe dancers? Music? Wait, music. Harmonica. Yeah, use the. There you go. Perfect. That should help. Dun, dun. I remember I took a computer class in high school, and we all got our own floppy disk that held 1.44 megabytes of info. And then the teacher, we would like save our little, we learned how to use Word and Excel, and we had to save our file on the disk and turn it in to the teacher, and she would check to make sure that we saved our documents just right. It was actually very useful. I learned a lot of how to use Word and Excel from that class. So it was actually one of the most... That class was one of the most useful classes I ever took because I still use things I learned from that class today in Excel and Word and stuff. A short distance ahead, a fresh net of water cascades from a stone outcrop, plummeting several feet into the basin below before settling in a cold, clear pool. Oh, Ava.
Did you come from Independence, too? I met this amazing man down there. He was handsome and so kind. I want to spend forever with him, but my father won't allow it. He wants me to marry this rich banker to connect our families. All my father ever does is tell me what to do, but I want to love who I love, not some rich snob. I just can't do it. I'm thinking of running away, going to find his wagon train so we can be together. You have to help me, please. Anything you can lend, I'll find a way to pay you back. You have my word.
Do I give her $50, you know, for love, that she can probably find love? I'll tell you about Douglas.
Douglas? That's him. You met him Independence after I left, you say? Thank you, travelers. I decided I will go and be with my love.
All right, take the damn money. I'm going to be nice. But you better give it back, okay? So I'm going to give you 50 now, and then you're going to resub for 1 year, okay? So $5 a month, and you're going to pay me back over time in an installment plan. Okay? Thank you, kind strangers. Perhaps it's fate we met for you to offer me such kindness. I hope we see each other again, and I shall introduce you to my beloved. $50 is worth $1,000 today. Damn. Frank. Let me be frank with you, because that's my name. It's a long way before the next place you can safely rest. Enjoy the peace and quiet while you can. Perhaps you should carve your name in the rocks, and my whole party did it, just to let the world know we were here. Give it a try.
Sure.
Yay! Each member of the party takes a knife, carves a name in the deep limestone cliff. Be forever preserved through the centuries. Trading. Traps, medicine, clothes, and coffee. I don't know about traps. Do I need traps? Nah. Okay, let's rest. Wagon bed is arranged a cozy sleeping space as possible. Party settles down for the night. All right, let's go ahead and depart. No one's died yet. It's a good sign. Go to Fort Kearney. Restore Roy's hygiene. Sure. Let's go down the middle, I think. We need to find hunting grounds. The party continues to journey west, leaving behind, spring behind. Each settler leaves, having filled their canteens and enjoyed their brief repose. 175 miles, my god. Probably Randall, resub for 27 months, says, Ava told me to give this to you. Sorry she won't be making it out west. Chat. Chat's being clever. I like it. I like it. You just bought this game? It's really fun. Oh, who has the best hunting? Oh, no. Probably the adventurer, which is the first one. We'll try her. Lucy wings the jackrabbit. The sound of the blast scares the animal and darts off into the grass quickly as a table, leaving a trail of blood in its wake. So you shot it, but you didn't kill it. So then, okay. So now you just scarred it for life. And we get nothing. Great. Daryl Van Horn, thank you for that resub. My ignorance of Greek myth always been my Achilles elbow. I don't feel so good, Mr. Stark. God, my brain. With a groan, Lucy heaves up her meal. She barfs everywhere. It seems something about the heart attack doesn't agree with her stomach. She has... Every time she eats the hardtack, she, like, goes, blech. It's not good. I see fish there. Maybe we can do fishing, a little fish. The fish seem to be in the water nearby. Prime location to cast a line. Try to catch a bite. Though bait is required, the party could craft some. Sure, craft some. A little time, party could craft some bait with suitable food for the party has in storage. Oh, we don't have anything that you can craft. Okay. Well, we'll push on so we don't have, can't. Eh. Great. Well, that fishing spot is not useful to me. Let's go down this way then. Restore Roy's hygiene. Let's do that. Let's repair that. There, doing that'll give me some extra bonuses. Group is hailed by a disheveled-looking couple on the side of the trail. Young girl nervously peeks out from behind them. Thank all that's good, all other travelers. You're the first people we've seen in some time, a sight for sore eyes indeed. What happened? Doesn't make much of a story, truth be told. Our wagon broke down, we weren't prepared. My husband did the best he could, but he has a broken arm, and without spare parts, we're stuck. We considered leaving the wagon, but it's just the three of us, me and my husband and little Mary here. Wouldn't survive this journey without with what we have left. Might be able to make it if only had some supplies. That's why I was hoping to, I'm happy to spot you. I beg for your assistance. Okay, I'll repair your wagon. Thank you, strangers. Can I do this without you? Let's try the farmer. She's probably got a good repair. Jane inspects the wagon to the best of her ability. Luckily, it doesn't take a skilled carpenter to recognize the problem. Jane is quickly able to identify the issue. The wagon wheel is warped out of shape. If the family were to continue on, the wheel could cause undue stress to the rest of the structure. Anything inside of it. The easiest solution would be to replace it with a spare part. However, it may be possible to fix it with some time and effort. We'll use one of our wheels. Replace the broken wheel part. Mommy, what's the lady doing? Hush, Mary, little shit. She's repairing our wagon for us. We should let her work. Well, it's like Mommy Dearest. Sir Kane, thank you for the gift subs. Appreciate that. Dr. Garby, thank you for their resub. Chrissy Mox, Benzar, Daniel Van Horn, probably Randall, Mr. JP. Thank you all for those subs, guys. Super kind of you. I know, let her cook. I'm not sure I have the skill to fix this. It's possible the wagon is beyond repair. What? Thank you for trying regardless. Kind stranger, we already had prepared for the sake to forsake the wagon attempt to make crossing without it, but with a small child, woman's. But, well, bye! Sorry, we aren't able to help you right now. We're in far too much of a hurry. Very well, suppose things cannot be helped. Wish you all the best, travelers. So, we need hunting. Where are the damn animals? Thunder rings out across the landscape. Rain pelts down on the party. Lightning frightens the oxen. Party could get past the wet weather as soon as possible, but be put at risk of getting sick. Alternatively, waiting out the storm may be a more viable option. Storm shows no sign of easing up. What should be done? Let's wait out the storm. The party packs inside the cramped wagon and battens down the covers. Damp, cramped, and uncomfortable party tensions are amplified. It's not what they signed up for in setting out on their journey. Storm rages all night long the next day, but eventually the rain clears. As all things must end, eventually the clouds clear and the sunlight returns once more. Oh, we're low morale. Forlorn, uh-oh. Use that harmonica. Eliza is no longer forlorn. Hopefully there's some hunting. We need food. Hunting is ideally suited to those who have spent time on the wilderness, but requiring shooting skill and ability to track prey through challenging environments. Those low stamina don't really carry out much meat. Let's try. We'll see if the priest is good at shooting. Nope, he's not. Damn it. Bam! 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 He's so slow. Bam! 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 Bam. room. 110 pounds of meat. It's not too bad. After assessment, Roy carries 110 pounds of meat back to the storage. Roy spent some time skinning the animals to get more valuable pelts. Yes. He managed to get some pelts to, without a knife, he couldn't carry as many. Knife can be locked, completing Bitter Winter Journey. Alright. Let's go there. So he doesn't like eating meat. She doesn't like eating hardtack. We can't win. The meat will eventually spoil, yes. A regular mold and a regular mound lies in the trailer. It's hard to make out quite what it is. It's a deer lying dead in the dirt, skin clinging to its thinly to its ribs. The creature seemed to have died of starvation, though it still has enough meat to feed a brave traveler or two. Who should gather the meat? Oh no. It's free food though, and we're hungry. We'll let Jane do it. Food is food. Jane cuts up as much meat as from the deer she deems edible. It's hardly hot cuisine, but might not be the difference between life and death. Have a nice barbecue. I know. I wish we could order a pizza or something. A loud crack sounds out as the wagon runs over a sharp, heavy rock. One of the wheels become warped by the impact. The wheel can be repaired manually. Takes some time. Entirely replace the wheel would be much quicker. Place the wheel. Repack. Okay, got some coffee. Let's move our pelts over here. Wayfaring on you. N69 Key, thank you for the 74-month resub. This on console? I believe it's on even mobile, if you want to play on mobile. Like, it seems like a fun iPad game. Campsite set up from wash basin bathtubs to make use of nearby spring. Grab two to restore hygiene. Yes. All right, let's wash up. We dirty. Thank you. Party spent some time thoroughly scrubbing themselves. Glad to be free of their swamp ass and grime that comes with grueling travel. I'm glad the swamp ass is gone, chat. Traveling for days on end with no showers. Ugh. Oh, the U.S. Army! It's already over. We're barely out of Alcove Spring and we're falling apart. Please, you must help or not reunite us. None of us can make it to Oregon alone. Who are you? I'm Thomas J. Farnham, but collectively we're known as the Peoria Party. We left from the county of Peoria, intent on blazing a trail straight through Oregon. We organize ourselves as a military would, strict, careful, and disciplined. In this fashion, we doubt the name of the Oregon Dragoons. I led the troop. Things were going well for a time, albeit a brief time. I see we're nowhere near Oregon, and we've already split. Tensions were simply building beyond repair. Even as a group, we were struggling. Can't imagine any of us will survive for a long time. For long alone.
Please, you must help us. Sure. Thank you. We will serve to take some clothes and medicine with you. If any of the boys are injured, they may require immediate attention on the trail. You'll find my boys scattered across the trail at various places. I'll make my way to Blue Mountains. Please rest as many of them as you can on your way there. Sure. Snake. Oh, we are pushing on strenuously. Was this hunting ground? Hungry. Jane, hedonistic, binges on the wagon's food supplies, consuming more than any one person should be able to fit in one go. She swallows it down, discarding anything not to her immediate liking. That's better. Jane, you gobbled up our meat? You hedonist? Food supply looking a little worse for wear. Jane feels much better. The party, on the other hand, feels a little differently about the now missing supplies. Son of a bitch, Jane. What the hell? She's like, oh, I gotta gobble some meat real fast. Not cool. I don't know, like, what? Typical Jane. Classic Jane, even. She got the munchies, I guess. You fed Jane shitty food. Well, we're all starving here. It's not just her. We only got a little bit of... We got hardtack left, which is nasty. Ahead, a cluster of buildings laid out in a square about 4 acres wide, surrounding a copse of cottonwood trees. As the wagon approaches, the sound of lively bustling comes into earshot. You arrived at the fort. Who would you like to heal? Lucy? Guide now available. You've unlocked a new journey. Help Stali train her son the ways of survival as they travel towards the winter hunting grounds. Successful completion unlocks the physician class and multiple new journeys. Ooh. Very nice. Knows nobody. Thank you for the 45-month resub, it says Dan Bear. Congratulations, your party has reached Fort Kearney. Dun, dun. That took 22 days? My god. What's the game being played on? We're playing on a chair right now. Ashi PC. It's called the Oregon Trail. I'm just kidding, okay? But yeah, playing on PC. Andrew Martinez, thank you for sharing the live stream on the TikTok chat. Appreciate that. You love this game? It's really fun. I believe it's even on iPad, if you got like an iPad or a touchscreen. Because the way the buttons are laid out, they're big, they're good, easy to press. Even if you got fat fingers like I do. Alright, let's see. Talk. Jane. Mommy, look, it's the people from before. My, you're right, Mary. Ho there, travelers. Glad to see you safe, friends. As for us, well, it was touch and go for a moment there. After you were unable to determine whether what was wrong with our wagon, we had to wait and pray. Thankfully, not long after you left, a wagon train arrived and we were able to buy a new wagon. It's expensive, but it saved our lives. Mommy, tell them about the gift. Hush, Mary, you little shit. I will. My daughter stressed that we should repay your kindness, and I wouldn't want to disappoint her. Please take this. Jane hands the party a small, wrapped gift. It's a harmonica. How fucking awesome. Thank you. That'll save our lives.
You know, you weren't able to fix the wagon. You stopped to help. That means a lot to us. It was my daughter's idea, so I hope you accept this little gift, as it may serve you well. Comes time to say farewell again, friends. This time it is under better circumstances. Pray you don't suffer any misfortune and arrive safely at your next destination. Bye-bye! As many people are leaving the area out west, it seems there is earliest hazards of the trail not are enough to make some people reconsider their journey. William Thomas. Ladies and gentlemen, are you tired of hitching your wagon to odoriferous pack of oxen? What if I told you there's a better way? A new mode of transportation that will change your life forever. Enthusiastic gentleman's giving a speech to anyone who will listen. Forget everything I told you about traveling by wagon train. What I propose is nothing less than a total revolution in overland travel. But how is that possible, you say? My overland navigation company will take all the guesswork out of westward travel. Why, all you need to do is rent a seat on one of my fantastic inventions and pack your finest clothes. I, William Thomas, will take care of everything else. And what is this invention, I hear you ask? Imagine, if you will, a grand fleet of darn tootin' prairie schooners, all operating on wind power. Heard that right? Wind power. Carries our forebears across the Atlantic Ocean, now it can carry you across the continent. There's plenty of wind on the prairie. I say, why not make use of it? All you need to do is build the first prototype is a small investment. And I am an honest man, offer a generous percentage to anyone willing to assist me. Mention the investors. Investors in Gillsburg, you say? Well, that's exactly what I need to make my dream reality. I'm fortunate indeed to run into you. Wonder if you might be willing to talk to these investors for me. You could tell them about my exciting opportunity. The public has not been very receptive to my ideas thus far, and I can't afford to keep lodging here at Fort Kearney. Sure. He sounds super trustworthy, chat. Yeah, I know. Travelers, it's good to see some faces on this trail. I hope your journey is going well. We've only had a few issues ourselves. Say, you haven't encountered a young woman named Ava, have you? She's my daughter, ran off with some flop-a-doodle. She's engaged to a nice young banker, traveling with us, and she has flagrantly disobeyed me. If you see her, tell her we'll be waiting at Fort Laramie for 4 days. What happens after that is her problem. Look, if you keep your eye out for me, I'll make it worth your while. I will tell you about Ava. What? You helped her run away? You damn hooligan? Where'd you get off butting into my family's business like that? Leave! Get out of my sight! Sorry. Dan is the man. Thank you, Olive Jomo. Can we trade? I want to sell my pelts. I will sell all the pelts we have. Thank you. $25. Oxen, clothes, bullets, toolboxes, traps. How much are traps? 28 bullets for... Let's haggle. Eliza, please haggle for us. Did you fail? I'm afraid the price is quite firm, like my butt. Eliza attempts to reason with Buck, but it is unsuccessful. Price remains unchanged. Dan Hooligan, I know. I guess I can trade some bullets. Kind of the same thing, trying to hunt. Could really use some sort of food if we can get some food. Nope. Kind of out of food. That's not good. Services. Barber. How is everyone's? Let's rest. Let's pay for the lodging so we get some good rest. Room simple enough, adequate. Welcome change from sleeping on the trail. Oh, there's a store. Let's see. Oh, a store. What do you sell that? Let's buy some of that. Also buy some damn bait. And per Google, $25 is worth $975 today. Really? That's quite the inflation there. I have meat. I don't know if I want to buy more meat. Ideally, we'll hunt it. Let's look at our wagon. We got traps and stuff, so we should be fine. Move that there. This is fine. We got plenty of bullets. We got some wheels. All right, I think we're fine. All right. Thank you, sir. Okay, let's depart. We're fine. Everything's great. You want to go to Julesburg, or do you want to go to Courthouse Rock? Busy way station westward. Immigrants, popular location, trades, good local peoples. Let's just go straight for the rock. I don't think we want to go out of our way right now. There's a person, dragoon sighting, or hunting ground. We need that. That's what we need. Travel that way. As party leaves the clearing behind, the minds wander to those who are yet to follow. How many more of you Twitch people that are watching will follow the stream? They wondered. It's a good question. Courthouse Rock. You played Diablo 4 yet? Yes, we played a ton of it. I've been playing mostly Druid. Want to make a sorcerer character at some point, as it seems fun. A small fishing hole comes into view, not present on any maps or in any guidebooks. May very well be teeming with fish. A good opportunity to catch some fresh fish to augment the wagon stores. Let's go fishing! Oh god, who's got good... as patience with good attitude? Well, not Jane. Let's try, Eliza. She's got 3. So, move the character, cast a line, reel when the catch... Okay. Is there a way to see... how many... like, sea fish? Oh, there's one. Yeah! No? I guess I gotta press it as soon as it happens. Okay, we got one! Yay! A largemouth bass.
Yeah, I like a nice bass. Oh, sorry, I meant bass. Oh, there's a fish there. Yeah! More fishing! I love me some fish. Oh my god! Trophy quality toad. Oh, hell yeah, we caught Le Pepe. Green sunfish, as bad as it gets. Green sunfish, oh, very good one. Oh, another one. When did this game come out? I feel like it was years ago. Yeah, Diablo 4 is tons of fun. We've been playing a ton of it. It's just, like, so addicting. That was, like, a big fish. A catfish! Oh, that's good eating. Well, they taste nasty unless you deep fry them, but they are big. Inches, very satisfying. Another frog, not so satisfying. Ooh, there was a big fish right there, but it's gone now. Well, sometimes when you're hungry, you just want to put a big, giant bass in your mouth because you're hungry. I missed that one. Oops. A walleye. That's a good one. Caught the maximum number of fish you can carry. Okay, in game then. Boom. Well, it caught us a ton of fish. 120 pounds of fish, managed to bring it all back to storage. Without a proper knife, she can't properly clean the fish, and only some of the meat is obtained. Nice when locked and clean, a bitter winter journey. Oh, no. Everyone is... We could use the harmonica to... So let's use that. Move that over, and then we got the fishies. We'll drop that one because it's getting very old. What is that? Used to trade. Discard that one. I think we can go for filling. We got so much extra food now. Oh no, it's raining. It means we're gonna start getting, uh-oh. Why are they in the road? Stay back, citizens. There's been a murder. A murder most foul. Oh, I see. You're that group the captain's got hunting us down. I had you pegged the minute I saw you. Detective's intuition, as it were. I could use your assistance on this case. Very well. If you help me track down the killer, I'll return to the captain as soon as I'm able. Sure. Excellent. With your help, I'll have this case solved in no time at all. I've compiled a list of clues, suspects, and pieces of evidence. Simply tell me what you wish to inspect, or let me know when you're ready to make an accusation. Give me the overview of the case. All right, chat, I need your help. There's been a murder. So someone out there has committed a crime, and we have to find the clues and interrogate the suspects. So make sure you're keeping notes. If someone seems sus in their line, you say, you shout doubt in chat. All right, here we go. Everyone was present as part of a wagon train heading to Oregon, with the exception of Quill, who arrived only yesterday. The others have been traveling together for the better part of a month now. Some have known each other longer, some less. Until now, there's been no infighting. One of the victims was Elias Farthing. He funded the expedition and was the de facto leader. He wasn't well-loved, but as far as I can tell, he also didn't have any explicit enemies. For the most part, their journey seems to have been normal, except that they've been harassed by thieves a lot more than usual. These thefts have been targeted, efficient. It's likely that somebody on the inside has been helping them somehow. I've compiled a list of clues, suspects, and pieces of evidence. Alright, give me the evidence. Stumbled across the evidence I could finally know when you take a close look at the crime scene. The body of a middle-aged man lies face down in the mud, his fatal wound clearly visible in the center of his back. The body was sunk deeply into the mud, suggesting he's been lying there for some time. Several boot prints are scattered around the mud. One distinct set stands out of average size. Man's clothes are intact except for some small stains and rain and scattered mud. No injuries anywhere other than the fatal one in his back. It's unlikely that he fought against the attacker. Nothing about the crime seems to stand out. I estimate the time of death to be around 8:30 last night, caused by a single clean stab wound to the back. Footprints make for a difficult clue, unfortunately. The only footprints that are visible are those made after the rain had started. I stumbled upon a ruined letter. We found a letter on Elias's body, but it was so rain damaged to be illegible. Still, there's a bit to be gleaned from it. The handwriting was messy. Certainly was written by Elias's hand. You ask me, this is our motive. The killer wasn't able to retrieve it, though I can't say why. From what we can make out, looks like it was addressed to an external party, rather than someone from the train. It's likely how our mole was communicating with the bandits. Unfortunately, the rain did them a favor. It's not much use to us now. Murder weapon. Alice was killed with a single thrust from this knife, of that I'm certain. The standard hunting blade that we found anywhere, with one distinctive feature. It's been customized to have a left-handed grip. That's our first biggest clue. As I said, the knife is otherwise unremarkable. The blade itself isn't warped at all, like the eyelids fought back. Just the body soft supports this. The untarnished condition of the blade also suggests that it was used efficiently, as your killer was almost certainly left-handed. Alright, suspect dossier. Taking the liberty to compiling some information on each of our suspects. Each suspect provides a writing sample so we could compare it to the note. I watched as each wrote the sample so I could see which hand they favor. Know which you'd like to learn more about. Quill Peabody is a reporter, one of those academic types. You'll have to come in and pick as a killer, but you never really know. It doesn't seem bad, just sort of timid, I'd say. You probably came here to speak with the deceased. I know they conversed briefly before Elias perished.
but you're better off asking Quill about details. This game's called The Oregon Trail. We're currently solving a murder mystery here right now by gathering the evidence and the suspects. He's not allowed to remember the train he makes, which makes him a bit of a mystery. I still don't recognize he's got murder in his blood, though. As to his attributes, the man wrote his sample right-handed and wears large boots. So that's going to be no. We want left-handed people. Gareth Fairfield. Let me see. Are you left-handed? Yes. Gareth has left-handed and is average foot size. This is the only fellow who seemed distraught that the murder occurred at all. That doesn't absolve him, but his reaction strikes me as genuine. Look, he's still a suspect. Everyone's present who... Okay. He seems upset. Kellogg. You are... ambidextrous. Uh-oh. Although he was equally skilled at each hand, his handwriting sample was horrible. Marshall. Right-handed. Okay, so we're dealing with these two suspects, Gareth and... Oh, wait, Gurney. Mr. Gurney. What is your... right-handed and small foot. All right, let me read the stuff on Gareth. Man serving the deceased, his butler, if you will. As far as I can tell, the man is nothing but loyalty up till now. Who knows what could have transpired between the two of them. Gareth wrote a sample with his left hand, average shoe size. Seems distraught. How about Kellogg again? He's bad news. He got an infamy around here. Never killed a man, far as I know. He's done all sorts of bad besides. They're a prime suspect for the thefts. He's also long-term enemy of Marshall. Two have been odds of years, as far as I can tell. He's ambidextrous, wears average-sized boots. Handwriting sample was horrible. Not sure if it was ugly or right or just faking it. Let me interview Kellogg. What do you want? Your alibi? I was out camp practicing my aim. No idea what time it was, but it wrapped up and came back to camp. On the way, I passed where Elias died. Thought it was dark enough that I couldn't see anything. Didn't know some fella scurry off in a hurry. Can't be much more than that. My man is whoever that was being the killer. Your relationship to the victim? Elias saw the fella around time again, but didn't care to know him. Didn't care to know me. Was the one to get involved with shady folk. Folk like myself. Pass hardly ever crossed, not much else to say. Examine him. The vicious-looking man whose hands are never far from his holster. Definitely spent plenty of time outside civilization and outside the law. A large, fresh bruise adorns the right side of his face. Wonder about the bruise? Well, I got Marshall thank for that one. Two of us ain't exactly friends, but hitting me was a first. Not sure what I done to deserve it. You'll have to ask him. Let's talk to Gareth the butler. Alibi? Let's see, I was preparing Elias' dinner for us in the wagon when I glanced inside to see Elias talking to somebody. That would be around 7:30. Never came back. As soon as it started raining, I went out to check on him, and that would have been around 9 o'clock. Found him lying in the mud. Hope he catches the killer soon. Relationship? Worked for the man. I was a valet, chef, attendant, so forth. Resolved matters he hadn't the time nor stomach to solve for himself. Hope he catches the killer soon. Norma's supposed man looks less like a servant, more like a bodyguard or soldier. He's well-dressed and maintains a neat composure in spite of the rain. It said Marshall punched him. Let's see why. You hit Kellogg? Saw that, did you? Well, I'll make no excuse to hit him, all right. You asked me, it's not even half what he deserves for killing Elias. Why do you think it was Kellogg? Why do you think it was Kellogg? Not much for deck work, are you? Shoe size fits those found by Elias' body. The blade used to kill the man was fitting left-handed grip. Kellogg is ambidextrous. He also unaccounted for at the time of the murder. I'll make a paper he's done, mark my words. Alibi? Saw Kellogg heading off his gun at the ready, so I decided to follow him. That must have been around 8:30. Fortunately, the rain made it hard to follow him. Returned to camp. By the time I made it back here, Elias was already dead. You asked me, it's no mystery who did the deed. Your relationship? The man who hired me to leave the caravan, he was a man with demons. Like any of us, he maintained the honor as long as I knew him. Grabbing up to him is a damn shame. Marshall's sturdy, stout man, confident posture, and grand sturt beard. His clothes are immaculate. I mean, it's looking like that one guy, but I don't know. It's a little too easy. Alibi? I went to bed at 7 on 7, perhaps. Only arrived this morning, so I thought I was still tired. Certainly not in the mood to be wandering about or conversing with anybody. Couldn't fall asleep for some time. Heard gunshots at one point, but it wasn't until after the rain started that I managed to fall asleep. Can I help you? Relationship? I'm a reporter, Elias. I had only properly spoken once. Told me he had news to share, but he had to procure evidence first. Frankly, I was in rain baffled. I don't know what news he was talking about, what evidence he was attempting to produce. Can I help you? Tall, thinly dressed man seems bothered by the rain, and his eyes are nervously darting around the gathered group. He seems nervous. Gurney Goldman. Alibi? Relaxing my wagon. It's what I'd be doing right now if you weren't accosting me. At one point I heard gunshots. See what was the matter. It seemed the usual. It was actually around 8 o'clock. So I went back to nurturing my favorite hobby, being alone. Relationship? I knew almost nothing about Elliot or Elias, whatever his name was. We're companions of circumstance. I don't believe we were ever conversed. Gurney is a thinly stern-looking man, pocket watch, hangs out of the wrist. What is it? Alright, well. Quill Peabody seems sus. Timid. You reportedly came in to seek with the deceased. I know they conversed briefly before Alice perished. Right-handed. Premier Porter, we have plenty of samples of his handwriting, though not exact match to those found at the scene. Samples were the closest match of the group. Large boots. Alright, I think it was Quill. Accusation? Quill Peabody. Yes. So, look there. We'll start with the method. First, the Quill's right-handed. It'd be usual for him to use a left-handed knife. Can you explain that? He's not right-handed. I think Carly, oh. Could have been Kellogg, though. I don't know. Quill Peabody. Victim not dead. Evil twin. Two killers. Nope. How about Kellogg? How does that fit? He's ambidextrous. So his writing sample is very different from the letter. Can you explain that? The rain smudged it. What? No! God damn it! Son of a bitch! I wasn't guessing, I was trying to piece it together, alright? I had a plan. I couldn't figure out who did it exactly. There's not enough clues. Let's repack. Repair. Increases meat gain from hunting. Oh, consumed automatically. Dun, dun, dun. Well, I think it was one of them. There was lots of clues, but nothing like quite that was just like, oh, it must be this person. A coyote growls at the party. The party stops and waits to see how the coyote react, but makes no moves. What should be done? Approach the coyote, sure. Who should approach the coyote? It was Marshall. Notice the bruise from hitting the other dude with his left hand. Really? Who should approach the coyote? Jane, you're a farmer. You like animals, right? Now that she's closer, Jane notices the coyote has something in its mouth. The coyote growls. Jane doesn't move to attack. Should Jane approach? Yeah, go investigate it. Cody whines as Jane bends down but makes no move to attack. Carefully takes the sack from the Cody's mouth. Open the sack, it appears to be a collection of NFTs and an ad that says, please buy our NFTs today. We need your money. This is not a scam, we promise. Perhaps supplies that the previous party left behind. Harmonica and some medicine. I'll take it. Coyote. Having passed along its gifts, scampers off with a whine. Jane's a little bit confused why a wild coyote bequeathed the gift, but figures it may be best to not look a gift canine in the mouth. Well, that's weird. Just some random coyote gifter. We got so much food we can eat. Give the oxen a chance to breathe. Sure. We'll let the oxen, like, you know, get a little breather. Right, let's go save a dragoon. Ouch! Tripping over a small bump in the rough, Roy finds himself in the dust. Little Sword picks himself up and keeps walking. You stupid son of a... Come on, buddy. Work with me here. Please, wait! Why are you hiding in a bush? Thanks for stopping by. I've misplaced my garments. Can you help me? The man stands by the trail, barely concealed by a shrubbery. Sure. Here, have some. Why are you naked in a bush? How does that even. Much better. Less nippy in more ways than one. Please take my medallion. I'll regroup with the captain once I have a chance to warm up. What the hell? I don't even know. He must have got really drunk and then someone stole his clothes, maybe? I don't know. Thank you, Akai and Tomo and Clindos, for those resubs, guys. The Knights of Knee would love that shrubbery, you're right. Rest might ease the suffering. Hurrying along may invite worse injuries. I will rest. Why not? The party pauses to give Roy some time to recover. After some time, the pain in Roy's leg abates. He feels well enough to continue walking. All right, let's continue. Courthouse Rock. Amputated? Oh, God. Let chat not be my doctor if I get a slight injury on my leg. Several travelers mill around, wagons unpacked, campfires lit. Seems to be a popular camping ground. Might be safe to spend the night and restore some stamina. Let's tell stories. Party sits up late telling stories about their lives. Get a little bit of insight as to what their skill levels are. Help us make decisions later. Baked potato, thank you for the sub. I appreciate that. While feeding the oxen, Lazard observes that one of the beasts seems lethargic. It's breathing labored. Might be sick. A full day's rest or additional food may restore its vigor. Let's give it some... Let's inspect the ox first. Farmer believes the problem might be a mild form of colic, easily treated with water, drink, a moment to roam freely. It's in no time the party is able to continue on. Thank you, farmer lady. I know, giving it 30 pounds of flour, but it is an oxen, and so it is big, if that makes sense. Do oxen eat flour? I guess maybe, I don't know. If you're hungry, eat whatever you can find. Oxen don't like to eat grass in this area though, because it's pretty plain. Are those ancient stones ruined castle jutting from the earth? No, they're a courthouse and jail rocks. So do landmarks, slightly natural origin. Let's trade. Let's sell fish. We offer $1 per fish. Let's haggle. Yeah. That seems fair. $2 per fish. Hell to the yeah. Let's sell 50 fish. It's $100. It's not bad. Trades. I know, slightly improved is double. That's a little more than slightly. Yeah, I know. It's a little. She's a banker, though, so she's used to robbing people. You know, just with a smile. Toolboxes, grease, flour. We'll take one medicine. Dun, dun, dun. How many toolboxes do I have? I do need some tools. We're getting low on them. Yeah, I can fit them in there. Okay, let's trade for the Is it random each time? I guess I only have one fish, so I'll take it. $64 flour. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, it seems like it randomly generates every time. Or the time changes and it generates it again. Alright, well, I guess we don't need it. We shall rest. Get some sleep. Restore our vigor, and then we will Anyone new? Nope. Okay, let's depart. World boss in 20 minutes? Awesome. Chimney Rock. Avoid a broken leg, get 190 stuff, and collect pelts, get resources. Let's go. I guess go for the fish again. That was some good, like, money. Does the Oregon Trail have world bosses? Yes. Back in the Oregon Trail, giant bosses would spawn, and the parties would have to defeat them and get loot. Just like that? Yeah, there we go. Bison spotted. Jane spots a young sapling on the side of the road. If cut and properly stripped, might serve as a strong wagon tongue. Who should cut the sapling? The only one I haven't tried their skill at is Lucy. So we'll see what she has. She's got three. She tries to cut and strip the sapling, but after hours, it is evident that it won't hold up to the vigors of being a wagon tongue. The project is abandoned. 2 hours? How did that take 2 hours? Oh god, it's him again. Oh, well, it's you. Listen, I'm not really in the mood to talk right now. I tried building my wagon, wind wagon, without any funding, but it was a complete disaster. I don't think I'm cut out for this inventor business after all. All my dreams have come crashing down, just like my flying machine prototype. Maybe I'll see you again in the future. Feet firmly planted on the ground. Oh, he failed? Prepard's falling. Sorry. You fucked it up, kitty cat bar language. I did not successfully win all the way. That's how we say it to be subtle nowadays. You can't just say you lost. You'd say you didn't win as much. You know? It's gotta be gentle. Let's go fishing. Let's try Roy. Ooh, he's got a six. You know how we are, chat. We love our fishing. Boom. Fishy. Woo! Oh, another frog. Thank you, Pepe. Thank you for feeding us. Oh, toad again. Hopefully get a bigger fish. I think they're worth a lot more. I don't know the difference between a frog and a toad are. Ooh, another trophy fish. Like, what's the difference between toads and frogs? Is it warts? Is that what separates them? Oh, frogs are aquatic and toads are land-based. Oh, that makes sense. That's a much easier way to distinguish the two. Fishing, I used to fish, but then it took a turkey-locious to the lawn. Aww, Red Dead. Red Dead 2, it's such a sad story. I know, Arthur. Hello, Bailey and Amber. Where's this game found? It's on Steam, it's on iPad, it's on consoles, I think. It's everywhere. It's a really fun little remake of the Oregon Trail. I only have 3 bait left. Uh-oh. I gotta make them count by making sure we get a big fish. That one seems pretty beefy right there. Come on, big fish. Trout is okay. £100 of fish, not bad. That's a lot of fish. Knives can be locked by completing the Bitter Winter. Oh, no. Well, we'll put it up there if using that. Perfect. Kazuya, I thought for sure that, like, as you were aging, you were getting more mature. You were, like, your jokes were getting more, you know, like, adult. But nope. We're still making the master joke with me talking about bait. I see. Waggler's to the hall with almighty crack at the wheel. Strikes a rock sticking out of the dirt. Sudden movement of the wheel cresting the rock as the cracked the wagon's front axle. Axle was still used, but dealt carefully. They probably should consider repairing the damage before things get worse. Let's repair, please. You failed? Despite Lucy's hard work, she fails to improve the condition of the wagon. Oh, no. That's bad. Oh, no. Is my wagon wheel just gone now? Oh, no. It's just gone. Just poof. Well, that I just hope we don't... Our wagon doesn't break now. Yeah, computer day at school was about playing SimCity, Caesar, and Oregon Trail. Good stuff. Towering stone spire erupts from the earth ahead. At its base is a large mound, although its massive pillar was once a single mountain. It now sculpted to a fine point. Looks like Chimney Rock, one of the trail's most storied landmarks. I didn't break a leg. So we got a bunch of flour. Okay, I need toolboxes. Trade all that flour I got. Medicine, coffee. No, we'll need those. Sell my fish. Yes. probably eat my fish, though. I got plenty of money. Alright, let me use the toolbox here to repair all of those. Okay, food soonly to be freshly eaten. Food is consumed daily on the rat. We got so much flour. We can afford to sell it. Let's sell our fish. Let's haggle. Thank you, Miss Banker. I will sell all of the fish. Give me that money. Let's go ahead and rest. Boom, 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 boom. The wagon bed is rearranged in a cozy as sleeping space as possible, and the party settles down for the night. I have no idea. Somehow she went to fix the wheel and the wagon, and then the wheel just went poof, gone. All right, let's talk. Anyone got a quest? No. All right, let's set out again on our perfect journey. Fort Laramie. What is in here? Oh, none of that matters. Let's go up that way. Okay, no one get dysentery. No one get cholera. No one get tuberculosis. No one die randomly. I've been checking the flour. Listen, some of it has become waterlogged. Begun to clump together. Most of the flour could probably be saved if it was sifted to remove the moist portions. Could be far more time-consuming process to be discarded in the whole bag. We'll discard the 28. We got plenty. We got lots of it, so we'll be fine. We gotta get there before winter happens, or we're gonna be in big trouble, Chet. Hello, Vixku, and DJ Crazy says, "Hi, Dan's Gaming Chat, it's my birthday today." Feels birthday, man. Let's give DJ Crazy some birthday wishes. Party spies a small thicket of shrubs, each covered with small red berries. If gathered, it could have medicinal properties that could be useful. Sure. Let's have him do it. See if he's what his score is. A 3. He harvests a moderate number of berries, though he crushes a few in the process, carries a handful back to the wagon. Herbal remedies. How much our food do we have left? We got plenty, so we're okay. Let's keep traveling. 165 days until winter. We gotta be fast. Boom, 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 boom. Looks like hunting. Let's have Jane try it. She's got a 2. Damn it. That's fine. Let's hope we can get at least a few. Damn it! Okay, another one. Take that! Oh dear! Okay, she got a lot of food there. 170 pounds worth. That's not bad. It's not bad. Yeah, the game's on Steam. It's I think it's on console. Who ate the cheese wheel? Did someone eat a cheese wheel? Is that a Skyrim reference? She managed to cut 170 pounds of meat, but only had enough stamina to carry 100 pounds back to what? Thanks to a carefully played trap, she also managed to eat 30 pounds of extra meat. Tame some pelts. Well, fine. Whatever. Daddy, look! Oh, God, it's them again. Daddy, look, it's the people from the party before. Are you going to invite them to the birthday party?
We'll see, sweetheart. Hello there, travelers. Unusual we meet again, though I imagine we're simply going the same way. Regardless, my daughter sure is happy to see friendly faces. We have had more than our fair share of troubles today. I wonder if you might do us a favor. I know it's asking a lot of you. We're already in your debt, but I would like to help. I'd like you to help us make a birthday present for little Mary. She'll be 5 years old this year, but the present we bought her went missing while we were stranded. Jane would like you to make her a doll, but is having trouble deciding out the pattern. Who should help little Mary's design a doll? The banker. Maybe, I don't know. After a few hours of sewing, Liza and Jane finished making a doll for little Mary. It has an amusing lopsided grin on its face and mismatched buttons for eyes. Jane giggles when she looks at it. Well now, this is a charming little thing you made for little Mary. Be over the moon when she sees it. You have my thanks once again, travelers. We hope we see each other again in the future. Isn't Oregon all dense forestry? I think towards the end that's going to happen. It'll get more dense as we get further into the game. Let's put you right there. And we'll repair that. Oh, people. That's sus. I don't trust it. Several travelers are celebrating their journey. Whether they're honoring their victories, commemorating their fallen, is unclear. The party may be able to join the celebration and restore some morale. Let's set up camp. Let's, celebrate. The party celebrates with other travelers late in the night, forgetting their troubles, if only for a moment. Oh god, once Final Fantasy 16 comes out, I'm gonna play the shit out of that game. Take that back! Make me! Why are they fighting? What the? Don't fight, people! My head! Jane Hedonistic clutches her head in pain. She isn't sure what happened last night, but she sure is sure that it was a good time. Even if the others disagree. Oh, God. That woman's puking her brains out over there. That wagon's upside down somehow. You're going to watch the hell out of me play Final Fantasy? Yeah. Awesome. Dun, 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 The wagon was just sleeping. Is this an educational game? Like, slightly, but not really. Like, a little bit, maybe. It's mostly fun, but you could probably, like, get a teacher to let you play this in class because, you know, teaching history or something. A large walled settlement stands before the wagon. This is Fort Laramie, one of the principal supply routes on the Oregon Trail. Who would you like to heal? Guess we'll do Roy. You've unlocked a new journey. Cross the harsh desert or in pursuit of riches as a group attempts to carry as much ammunition to Fort Hall as possible before it explodes. What? Successful completion unlocks harmonica item and the carpenter class. Can you imagine being sent in the desert with a wagon and it's getting progressively hotter and all the stuff out there is going to explode if you don't get there fast enough? Dear Lord. Billy, thank you for that the hellos. There's a movie about that with a truck. Really? Well, are you talking about speed? It's not quite the same thing. It's more just a bomb. But, you know, kind of. Congratulations! Your party has reached Fort Laramie.